I'd like to reintroduce you to the concept of enthalpy. This is something you would have dealt with back in Chem 1. Enthalpy is delta H naught, where the naught is means standard conditions. And what we're looking at here are energy changes in reactions, going from the beginning to the end of the reaction. The delta H naught can be measured by the sum of the delta H of formation of the products minus the sum of the delta H of formation of the reactants. All of these values will come from a table, and it's this column here that you're looking at, delta HF naught. It's measured in kilojoules per mole. Let's look at a definition for heat of formation. So delta HF naught is heat of formation, and it's the energy change measured when a compound is made from its elements in their natural states. So an example of that would be, let's say we were making carbon tetrachloride, CCl4. That would be made from carbon, which is solid graphite. That's considered to be the natural form. And Cl2, a gas, is considered to be a natural form for chlorine. So that would be a balanced equation right there. And the delta HF naught of formation of an element is going to be zero. But for a compound, it's always something different from zero. So when this is made from these elements, this amount of energy, 128.4 kilojoules per mole, is released. Usually, heats of formations are negative because these compounds are usually more stable in relation to the elements from which they are actually made. All right, so going back to the tables here, you can see something like aluminum solid is zero, because that is the natural form of aluminum. But if you take a look, most of these values are indeed negative, again reflecting the fact that the compounds are more stable than the elements from which they're made. And you can see Be solid, boron solid, bismuth solid, they're all zero because they're all natural states. Let's see, bromine, Br2 is liquid, see that? That's zero. So that's how you know that Br2 gas is not the natural state, for example. Anything with zero is going to be the natural state. All right, so when we're looking at using these heats of formation and applying them, remembering that the heat of reaction, the enthalpy of reaction, can be measured by the sum of the heats of formations of the products minus the sum of the heats of formations reactants. So it's always products minus reactants. Then what we can do is we can have two kinds of reactions. We can have this one where the products are of lower energy than the reactants. See, energy is on this axis. This is the reaction coordinate going from the reactants to the products. And you can see that what's happened is that the products are less energy than the reactants. Now, since the equation is products minus reactants, then the small value minus a bigger value will give a negative value. We call this process an exothermic process, when the products are lower energy than the reactants. And therefore, the delta H naught of a exothermic process will always be negative. So when energy gets released, we're looking at a negative value for delta H naught. Conversely, if we take a look at a situation where the products are higher energy than the reactants, then what we're looking at is delta H naught is a big number minus a smaller number. We call this an endothermic process, and that's going to lead to a positive value. And again, it's all about relative numbers. Products are higher energy than reactants. Products minus reactants will give a positive value. The two features of the energy diagram that are important here, you've got the activation energy, and here's your delta H naught. It's just the difference in the energy between the reactants and the products. And you can see it in each instance here. The delta H naught is what we call not dependent or independent of the path, which means it doesn't matter how many bumps and whatever else goes on in this energy profile, it only matters about what the initial energy of the reactants is and the final energy of the products, and that's it. So it's always just the difference in the energy between those two.